Hello guys, this is Sham from Revity, and today we're going to look at the implementation of minimum size subarray sum in C++. So this problem and the logic behind it has been explained in detail by Sahithya. So if you haven't watched that video, please do watch it first. So in this problem, we're given an array here and a sum value. So we have to find out the length of the smallest subarray which has a sum of at least the given sum. So here, let's take a subarray 2, 3, 1, 2. It has a sum 8, which is greater than the given value of s here. So that satisfies the condition. One more subarray like that is 3, 1, 2, 4. It has a sum of 10 and satisfies the condition. But ultimately, we need the smallest subarray, and that's 4, 3 here. It has a sum of 7, and that satisfies the condition. So we have to return the length of that subarray, which is 2. So to solve this problem, we're going to be using the two-pointer approach with the sliding window technique. So if you're not familiar with the sliding window technique, do watch Vignesh's video on that. He explains it really well. Now let's look at the logic for this particular example. Here we have a two pointers I and j at the start of the array, a variable called current sum to hold the sum of the window at any point, and another variable called minimum length, which has been set to the maximum integer initially, because the first time we find out any subarray which satisfies the condition, it should be stored in minimum length. It will obviously be lesser than it and it will be stored there. So here we have two phases called the growing phase and the shrinking phase. So in the growing phase, we keep incrementing I and we increase the size of the window until a point that it satisfies the condition. And then we keep incrementing j to decrease the size and we keep checking if it still satisfies. So this will basically help us find out the minimum subarray which satisfies the condition. So to start off with, we have I and j the initial position now. So we include that, and our current sum is 2 in this case, which is less than s. So we increment it and include the next element. Now it's 5, it's 6 now, and when we reach this position, it's 8. So this is a subarray which satisfies the condition. So we have to update our minimum length here, which is nothing but I minus j plus 1, because I points to the start of the window and j points to the end. So once this is done, we start up our shrinking phase where we increment j and we see if it still satisfies the condition. It doesn't in this case, it becomes 6 and it's less than s. So we go back to the growing phase. Now it's 10, so we can check the length, it's still 4, and we start up with the shrinking phase and it still satisfies the condition here, so we can increment the minimum length. We can update the minimum length to 3 here. And one more time we increment j, it doesn't satisfy the condition, it's less than s. So we have to increment I here. And now the current sum is 9, greater than s, but the length is still 3. So we try shrinking it and we see that it still satisfies the condition with 7. So our minimum length here is 2, and you can't expand it, you can't grow it anymore or shrink it. So this is where it terminates, and our final output will be 2. We've got the right output. Okay, so now let's implement this logic. So initially we initialize the variables current sum to 0 and minimum length to the maximum possible integer. And then we use a for loop in this case, but you can use a while loop as well. So the two pointers I and j are initialized here, and you keep repeating this until I reaches the end. So it's less than the size of the array, and then you keep incrementing I. So it'll keep growing. So in the growing phase, all we have to do is add the ith element to our current sum. So that will be this. And the loop right now keeps growing our window, so it keeps incrementing I as well as increasing the value of current sum. So when we reach a current sum of at least S, we have to start shrinking. So here we do the shrinking phase. So that's nothing but we use a while loop here, and we say as long as the sum here satisfies the condition, we first check for a minimum length. So in this case, the minimum length should be the minimum of itself and the current length. The current length is nothing but I minus j plus 1. So once you've done this, you have to remove the jth element from the sum. So you actually have to remove, so that's you remove from that, and then you increment j. Now j is the next element, and you keep repeating this until it satisfies the condition. So this part will do that, and we keep getting a new minimum length if it decreases it. So once you're done with this, when you come out of the row, the minimum length will be stored in min length, which is what we return. So one more thing which you have to note here is that you might not always find a subarray which has a sum of at least S. So in that case, you have to return 0. But here we set minimum length initially to int max, so it will return int max. So for that, we use one more if statement here, and we check if the minimum length is the same as what it has been initialized initially. We return 0. So with that, it should work. So let's check. Yeah, so it works for the sample cases. Now let's look at the other case. Yeah, so in this case it worked for all. So the different types of cases you have in this is, one, first of all, you can find out the minimum sum, the minimum subarray length. So we've just seen the logic for that. Now in some cases you might not be able to find out, so we have a statement for that. And one more case which you usually get is because you have an array here, this array can be empty. So in this case, as you've seen, it won't enter the loop if the array is empty. So it'll directly come here, and we have a statement to handle that. So this code automatically handles all cases, and that's very fast. So now for the code optimizations. So the one thing which you might have already noticed is we have an if statement here, and then we start shrinking it. But the shrinking phase itself has a condition here in the while loop, and only if it satisfies this, it'll enter it. So this if statement initially was unnecessary. So you can remove that, and it still should work. And one more thing you can do here is, instead of having a if statement here and then returning two different things in two different lines, you can do that in the same line using a ternary operator. So that would be this minimum length is equal to the what you initialized initially. That's the condition here. And then if it's true, you return 0. Otherwise, you return minimum length. So this will help you reduce the lines of code here. Yeah, and that it still should work. Okay. So now let's look at the time and space complexities for this problem. We have our I pointer which goes to the end of the array always, and we have a J pointer also which you use in the shrinking phase. Now in the worst case, j can go till the end of the array, which is where I is. So both I and j traverse the loop, and so the time complexity for this case would be O of 2n, which is a linear time complexity algorithm, so it's quite efficient. And the space complexity here is O of 1. The reason for this is we didn't have to use any extra data structures in this case, except for the input array which we received. So it's O of 1. So that's it for this video. If you have any doubts, leave it in the comments below, or you can head over to the Discord group. Thank you for watching.